Is it summer? It's hard for me to remember what time it is even anymore. Amid all the backyard grilling, quarantine, slip and slides, and DIY kiddie pools, that's just me, you may have missed a development that could fundamentally impact the fight for the Senate majority in the fall. And it's this: Amy McGrath beat Charles Booker to win the Kentucky Democratic Senate primary. What? You say? Mitch McConnell isn't going to lose this fall, you say. Which, upon first glance, you're probably right. McConnell is a very able politician. It's how he has won 6 times in Kentucky and is currently the most influential Republican, aside from President Donald Trump, in the nation's capital. But Amy McGrath doesn't need to beat Mitch McConnell to reshape the Senate map. All she has to do is be competitive enough that she A, keeps McConnell focused on his own race, and B, forces him and potentially the National Republican Party to spend time and money ensuring that the Republican leader wins. Now, there's no question that McGrath is a remarkably, remarkably gifted fundraiser. In 2018, she raised more than $8 million in a losing bid for the House seat of Congressman Andy Barr in the 6th Congressional District. In that race, she became a viral sensation thanks to a kickoff video produced by Democratic ad whiz Mark Putnam that highlighted her military background. Now, in this race, as of July 16th, McGrath had raised, wait for it, $47.3 million, according to the Louisville Courier-Journal, which in comparison to McConnell, McConnell's raised $37 million, which is still a lot, for the race thus far. Now, it's worth noting here that McGrath is a less able campaigner than she is a fundraiser. As I noted above, she didn't win against Andy Barr in 2018, despite that being a very good year to be a Democratic challenger, and despite the fact she was incredibly well-funded. National Democrats won't likely admit it, publicly at least, but they aren't likely terribly concerned about McGrath's uneven performances on the campaign trail in the race against McConnell, as long as she can keep raising tens of millions of dollars to attack the Senate Majority Leader between now and November. Because if she can raise, let's say, $80 million total, then McConnell and the National Republican Party apparatus are also going to have to spend heavily to ensure that he wins again, despite the fact that Kentucky clearly leans toward Republicans at the federal level, a point I will prove by noting that the last Democrat to win a Senate race in Kentucky was Senator Wendell Ford's re-election race back in 1992. Now, this is where the strategy or strategery comes in. Remember that the amount of money via national parties and super PACs that will be spent on the battle for the Senate is finite. So let's say, for the sake of explaining how this all works, there's $200 million that Republican committees and super PACs have to spend on all of the competitive Senate races in the country this fall. The truth is, the actual number is probably likely to be much higher, but let's just say it's $200 million. McConnell, because he is not only the most powerful Republican in the Senate, but also because he raised tens of millions of dollars for the party and its related super PACs, of which the major one is staffed by, yes, longtime McConnell allies, will get as much money from these groups as he needs to win. So let's say that $20 million gets spent on the Kentucky Senate race to make sure that McConnell is insulated from the TV ad onslaught that McGrath's multi-million dollars in fundraising can buy. It's also $20 million that can't be spent on trying to reelect Arizona Senator Martha McSally, or Maine Senator Susan Collins, or North Carolina Senator Tom Tillis, or Georgia Senator Kelly Loeffler. You get the idea. And then there's this to consider. If McConnell, the best fundraiser among Senate Republicans, is focused on raising money for his own reelection race, he can't raise as much money for all of those senators I just named above who are more vulnerable than he is. Ditto for if he is pinned down in Kentucky rather than traveling across the country for events to collect cash for the most vulnerable GOP incumbents. And that, right there in and of itself, is a very big deal. Winning, when it comes to McConnell, isn't necessarily the goal for Senate Democrats as they try to net the 3 seats, if Joe Biden wins the White House, or 4, if he doesn't, that they would need to retake the Senate majority. Senate Democrats don't need Kentucky to get to the majority. In fact, there are roughly a dozen Republican seats that would likely fall before McConnell were to lose. Instead, keeping McConnell occupied with his own race has to be Democrats' goal. And because of McGrath's fundraising prowess, Kentucky could therefore be the key to Senate Democrats reclaiming their majority this fall, even if she loses. And that is the point. We make new point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Be sure to check them all out.